The soccer event is finally over. We no longer have to merge players and count badges. We have a short break until the fall event starts up, but today I wanted to talk a little bit about how the soccer event went. Thanks to all of you on my Discord server, we were able to track the Gold League progress threshold for nearly 100 different worlds across 15 servers over the course of the event. That's a lot of data, so let's jump right in. First, I do want to say that I'm happy to see that over 90% of my viewers were able to get the fully leveled Aegean Resort, and many also got the Athlon Abbey and Gentiana Windmills golden upgrades. As you might expect, the most popular daily special was the Epic Soccer Kit, which appeared on September 3rd, resulting in a massive spike in Gold League thresholds. The second most popular special was the Athlon Abbey Kit, which is understandable. The Windmill Farm Kit was also quite popular, however, it's hard to gauge just how popular it was due to it also falling on the first day of the event, when many players spent a lot of soccer balls regardless of daily special. You may also notice that US29's Gold League threshold is miles above the other US worlds, as it is the newest world on US servers. In fact, when we look at a list of all the worlds ranked by the highest league thresholds, US29 is first among them all. It's followed closely by the Norwegian worlds, which is kind of surprising. Germany's 23rd world also shows up, along with a smattering of other worlds. The US and Norway each have 4 worlds in the top 10, while Germany and the international server only have 1 each. In case you were curious, the servers ranked by average league progress are shown here. Norway actually does come out on top here, due to there only being a couple of worlds but many high spenders, with the US ranked second. The international server takes third. What this also shows us is that if you want to play on a server with low league thresholds, the Brazilian and Spanish servers look like great options for you. Overall, the average Gold League threshold was only 5,496, which wouldn't have cost that much more than what you could achieve for free. Of course, your mileage may have varied wildly depending on the server and world that you play on. Beyond that, I'll be posting the spreadsheet of all the data for you to dig through if you like. I'll link it down below in the description. I'll also be turning off responses for the progress submission form, so if you have any of the final progress submissions for a world that is missing from this list, just let me know and I'll add it. That's all for today, just wanted to do a short video on this data. I hope it was interesting. Stay tuned for more about the fall event and Guild Battlegrounds changes, and I'll see you all next time.